1660. Vincent de Paul and Louise de Marillac, considered by their contemporaries to be synonymous to charitable works, died. The lives that they touched continued their noble vision of helping the poor and the marginalized. Today, we remember with gratitude the lives of revolutionary charity and missionary zeal that our founders had lived and passed on to us. The love of St. Vincent de Paul and St. Louis for the poor transformed the indifference and apathy of the church and society towards the poor into concrete acts of charity and evangelizing missionary works. These great acts of dedication to the service of the poor started in 1617 when the first association for the poor, the Ladies of Charity, helped St. Vincent feed the hungry, nurse the sick and dying, and provide homes for the abandoned and victims of war. The works of charity grew and became more demanding. St. Vincent organized a group of priests to provide spiritual guidance and pastoral care for the poor. The priests of mission dedicated their priesthood to the neglected poor people in the countryside of France. And from this group, the Congregation of the Mission was founded in 1625. Later, St. Vincent, together with St. Louis, established the Daughters of Charity in 1633. This group of women dedicated their entire lives to the mission of keeping a shelter for the sick, taking care of the abandoned, and feeding the hungry. Today, after 350 years, we find ourselves organizing activities to commemorate the same event. Today, we celebrate